last night to take a 3-2 series lead on the Blazers. Nikola Jokic was great again, 25 points, 19 rebounds. Paul Millsap added 24. Denver is now a win away from a spot in the conference finals for the first time in a decade. So, Shannon, how big of a threat are the Nuggets to win the West?
I don't believe they're a big threat. I believe the Western Conference final is their ceiling, Skip. I don't believe they can beat the Warriors or the Rockets. They went 1-3 up against both of those teams this year.
Interesting.
With Joker and Murray, I believe they can get a game, but I don't believe they can beat either one of those teams to advance to the finals. So I believe the Western Conference finals is their ceiling.
I got to say, and maybe this is because I love the Spurs to a fault, but this team won me over against my team by beating my team, and it took all of every drop of seven games to do it, and they split in the regular season, so you can say, well, they're just barely better than the Spurs. But I thought the Spurs could advance to the Western Conference Finals, but I told you the toughest series is going to be these guys because Jokic is real.
he
is getting better by the dribble. And I remind everybody, even though he's only 24 years of age, he played 2 years of pro basketball in Europe.
Right.
He looks like a man to me. He plays like a man to me. He is not afraid. He is playing on a level that very few big men have ever played on. I used to say Tim Duncan was the best passing big man I ever saw. He's not in this guy's league. I'm sorry. I used to say Bill Walton. I know a lot of people don't go back that far, but Bill Walton was just an artist with the basketball at UCLA and for Portland. Remember, he was an MVP and they won it all.
Finals MVP.
He was. And he could really wheel and deal with the basketball. But not like this young man, and he is a man, can wheel and deal. I look up last night, he's throwing full court football passes for touchdowns. He's dishing, he's no looking, they're playing, the whole offense runs through this seven-footer.
He brings the ball up the court like a guard.
Just unbelievably gifted with the softest hands for a seven-footer I've ever seen. He tips as sweetly around the basket. He can stand flat-footed and just tip it in because he's got feel for it. He's got anticipation.
And he does all that with a 5-inch vertical.
I don't even know if he's got five. I think you're giving him an inch.
You might can slide a
maybe
sheet of notebook paper.
Maybe. Right under there?
Yeah, that's about all you got.
I got you. But he's playing on another level of artistry.
Mm-hmm.
And then I keep hearing the Nuggets are the youngest team in the playoffs. They're the eighth youngest team ever to make the playoffs. And then I look at Paul Millsap. He's been in the league since his 13th year. And he's a man. You want to talk about playing man-sized
basketball?
He finally
came to play last night.
Woo, did he?
Yeah.
He's a bull in the low post. Mm-hmm. And he's got all the, he knows all the slick moves. Mm-hmm. And he is so hard to uproot from the lane. And then I look at Mason Plumlee comes in and plays 20 minutes a night. He's 29 years old in his sixth year. Is that a kid to you? And I don't like Jamal Murray because of what he did to my Spurs, but I am grudgingly giving in to him because you want to talk about clutch shot making, free throw making, and he's in his third year and he's playing like he's in his 10th year because he's a man. Hmm. He knows how and he's not afraid. And he has that supreme arrogance about him.
Yep.
And it's starting to translate into their whole team feels like they got a chance because they got Jamal and Jokic. And when those two start playing pick and roll together, because they can both look at what Jamal did. Didn't he have 9 assists last night?
Yeah, 9 assists, 18-95.
Okay. All right, that'll work. And then they just come in waves of young athletes. And as unathletic as you might say Jokic is, every time I look up, there's another Torrey Craig or Will Barton or Monte Morris or Malik Beasley. They're just coming in waves. Mm-hmm. They defend at a high level. They're going to be a tough out. Again, is it possible Portland comes back and gets them? I don't think so, but it's possible because Portland's loaded, too.
Right.
They
sure.
got firepower.
Well, Portland didn't shoot the ball. Dame and
no,
CJ didn't get off the great starts last night, and the Nuggets rode that momentum. They better be careful now because the Nuggets are playing with supreme confidence. Portland's going to have to be on their best behavior. They're going to need a virtuoso from Dame, and CJ is going to have to play well because they have no answer for Joker. I mean, Aminu, Cantor, they can't battle him down on the block.
Well, it's funny because Cantor always got blasted for his lack of defense in Oklahoma City, and now he's your last line of defense against Joker?
Yeah.
You're kidding.
And if you can't stop him, Skip, you're going to have to offset some of the production point-wise, that Joker's giving his team. You can't let him outscore you, what, 25-9?
Yeah.
No, you can't Joker had 25, and Canada had 7.
Yep.
You can't get outscored like that, Skip. Because you remember the one big game, I think he had it against OKC, he was 25-18.
I know.
He needs those type of ball games to offset the production because Joker is almost averaging a triple-double in this, in this series.
I got you. And Mike Malone, for whom I haven't had the most respect, he has become the best post-game interview in basketball.
He's unbelievable.
He just opens up his heart and just pours it out on the table. You know, like,
he is good,
it's from the soul what he talks about.
Can you believe the Kings fired him?
I don't know. I can't believe a lot of things the Kings have done.
Oh, they fired Jokic. They just fired another coach. He almost got him in the playoffs. And what the Kings might be one of the youngest teams.
Well, they got Luke Walton. Okay, way to go.
Okay.
Okay, so Mike Malone, I never had that much respect for him as a coach, but he is growing on me like this team is because they feed off him, off his even keelness because he doesn't get too high or too low. And he's making a lot of nice strategic moves, a lot of nice rotational changes. And all of a sudden, this team, it is arriving. And as you know, the NBA playoffs are about star power.
Yeah, absolutely.
Jokic is a star, man.
Oh, yes. Oh, he about to be a superstar.
Like super.
Yes.
Superstar.
Man, they put Isaiah in, man. They can't get no time out of this, Skip. I mean, they're about 40 points in there, and Isaiah can't get no playing time.
I feel sorry for him. Boy, did he not miss his boat. Whew.
That's why Kawhi wouldn't go back out there.
Yeah, but still.
That money. The man playing through. His sister died tragically.
Quickly it changes.
Yes. Yeah. $100 million.
He had a career-threatening hip injury that finally required surgery.
But he played through it.
The other guy had a thigh bruise.
It could have been career. Had he played through it, it could have been career-threatening.
But for you to say that Denver is growing on you,
well, I just can't help it. And again, sometimes it happens to me where they beat my team and you start thinking,
you're like, okay, I want them to go. No.
It's not like that. I watch them so carefully against my team where every big moment, those two guys, Jamal and Joker, they just took the game over.
Mm.
And in the end, I said they had the two best players on the court with my
team
on the court.
Joker is one triple-double away from tying Magic Johnson for the most triple-doubles in his first playoff appearance.
Mm.
Let that sink in. Mm. Magic Johnson, Nikola Jokic.
You got it.
Well, Denver might be growing on you. Toronto, not so
Toronto,
much.
Toronto, why growing on me?
Are the Sixers officially done after their loss last night? We'll discuss that next.
The claw, no.
And I won't back down.
Todd, no.
You wouldn't just live with it if they did it. So.